Get ready to match the stars. Gary Crosby, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Mary Wicks, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Dillibont as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rivers!
Here we go again. We're so tied up here.
I mean, we've been all tied up here for days and days and days. But we're going to see if we can untie it with your assistance.
Right.
Here we have Maggie Lantizer and David Zive. We welcome them. They played one game to a tie. Then they went to a tiebreaker, and they tied that. Now we got to go to another tiebreaker. Are you ready for it?
Yes.
Would you stop fooling around here and play this game right? We'll see how this game ends right after we see about this. Shall we? Okay, here we go. Second tiebreaker. David Zive, you may have A or B.
B, please.
B. All right. David is a medical technician.
A tall medical technician.
He can play anyway.
6'7". Here it is. Hopalong Cassidy said, "The reason they call me Hopalong is that before I got my horse, I used to ride a blank."
Got it. Well.
It's all right. Okay, David. Hopalong Cassidy said, "The reason they call me Hopalong is, before I got my horse, I used to ride a blank."
Pogo stick.
Pogo stick. Pogo stick is good.
I don't know what I'm saying, but that dates you pretty good. Pogo stick
Pogo
hasn't
stick.
Been seen since high button shoes.
Where did I go wrong? I
what?
Thought I had it.
Really?
Yeah.
What
rabbit.
You think? Rabbit. They don't think you went wrong. They're with
so
you,
far
Gary.
On my side?
Right.
Wait, I did too. I said rabbit too.
Before I got my horse, I used to ride a rabbit. Hop along. Oh, yeah. Rabbits go hippity-hoppity.
Well, his name is Hoppy. That's his
Hoppy.
Nickname, Hopalong Cassidy.
Hoppy.
Isn't it Hoppy?
Right.
Hoppy.
Right.
Well, don't turn on me. I'm just trying to keep the show alive and moving.
Yes, in Christopher Robin. Don't you remember that famous phrase?
No.
He went hippity-hoppity.
I was reading more adult books at the time.
Oh, I see.
So, anyway, I couldn't think of the name of this animal for a while, so I put those things in Australia. Then it came to me, a kangaroo.
Kangaroo, that's a good jumper. David is looking for the answer, pogo stick.
I hope this won't embarrass anyone. Pogo stick.
Pogo stick. That's a bouncy device,
yeah.
Hopping along.
True, but you can't throw a saddle on it.
Really?
But you could on a rabbit.
You could. Okay. Well, David, they had another idea there from yours. Now, Maggie, one to tie and two to win. The lawyer said to the assembled relatives, "I'm afraid this will has an unusual requirement. Before I can read it, you all must be blank."
This will has an unusual requirement.
I'm afraid has an unusual requirement. Before I can read it, you all must be blank.
Most unusual. Right? Right, Gino?
Right.
You can't get no more unusualer.
Right.
Than that.
Ready, Chuck? Yay, Chuck.
I need all the terms
that you can
get.
Okay, Maggie. The lawyer said to the assembled relatives, "I'm afraid this will has an unusual requirement. Before I can read it, you all must be blank."
Drunk?
Drunk? Drunk.
It's unusual.
That is unusual.
Not a bad idea.
Rich grandfather died and they all got drunk at the reading of the will there. Is that what
I got
what
too
said?
Unusual, didn't I?
You got too unusual.
Dead.
He said dead.
they're with you again.
As long as I keep them straight.
Yeah, right.
They could come up after you. Those people.
Right, in the parking lot, they could get you. Okay.
With my reputation, this is going to come as a shock, but I said Dade.
Dade! Looking for drunk.
I didn't do a thing, Mr.
I know,
Rayburn.
But the gesture with your head was beautifully done.
Edward Everett Horton taught me that.
Dead.
The lawyer said most unusual requirement in this will. Before I can read it, you all must be drunk, according to Maggie.
Well, I'm all for it, but I said dead.
Dead. All right, Maggie, you're getting down to the home stretch here. You got to match one to achieve a tie again.
Dead.
Now, you got to match Joyce to achieve a tie. And if you don't, David will win. What do you say?
Not drunk, dead drunk.
Dead! That means David wins again. Maggie is leaving here with a pretty good-sized bundle of money. She's got $600 to her credit, and our best wishes for being on Match Game 77. Maggie, thank you. Goodbye, and while we're spinning her off, cheerful message we are going to get for you. Thank you. Here we are with David Zive, who's a lot taller than 6'5". Suppose you were in a play with him and you were doing a love scene. And he said...
What are you talking about? This is my twin brother.
Really? On his knees, he's taller than you are. 6'7", you are?
Right.
Do you use the same hair color?
Get back to your seat, you rascal. Do you use the same hair color? Now, David, here's the way it is. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, and we gave them pencil and crayon, and we said, you write down your best answer to this, Patrick Blank. And we'd be happy to give you $500 if you match the answer they gave us most frequently. And if you match their second most popular answer, you get $250, and then $100 for matching the third. And three of the six are allowed to help.
Gary.
Patrick Henry.
Yeah! Richard.
Patrick McGoohan.
Patrick McGoohan.
Yeah. Gentleman who starred in The Prisoner, the television series.
Oh, yes, indeed. Yes. Excellent.
Brett.
Very good. Just a minute. Something may come to me. But then again, something may not.
Give a Patrick McNee. Oh, yes. He did that series, The Avengers, with what's-her-name for so long.
Diana Rigg.
Diana Rigg. Now, so you have Diana Rigg. No, you have Patrick Henry, Patrick McNeil, and Patrick McGoohan.
I go with Gary. Patrick Henry.
Patrick Henry. You just mentioned him yesterday, didn't you?
Only
when you said,
I was
shoot
talking
if
about
you must.
Him at breakfast. I said, right. Whatever became of it.
Here we go. Patrick Henry. May we see the $100 number? Patrick Moynihan. Oh, yeah, Senator from New York State. All right, here we go with the $250 number. Patrick McGoohan is Richard's answer. All right, last chance for you, Henry. Here we go. Yeah. David, you picked up an additional $500.
Oh, yeah.
And that means you have a total of $600 now. However, you are going to play for 10 times the sum you just won, or $5,000. And we'll be glad to give you the money if you'll match one celebrity exactly. Whom do you call it?
Richard.
All right, here we go. Face me if you would, please. That's it. You can just stand on the blue dot. That's all right there. It's worth $5,000. All right, are you ready? Okay. Where are you, Richard? Oh, there you go. Here it is. Cork blank. C-O-R-K blank. Cork blank. Okay, David, he's made up his mind. We ask you to make up your mind. Give us the answer that he's written on the card. We give you $5,000. Cork blank.
Screw.
There are many thoughts that ran through my mind. But...
What was one of them?
What would you... Cork...
What were you thinking of?
Dad talk.
Judge!
All right, go back. Judge. Go back.
Tell us your answer now.
I will. What were one of the ones you were thinking of?
They went out of my mind.
Screw.
Comes Isabel Smith. Let's welcome her. Isabel Smith coming out here now. Hello, Isabel.
You know David here? He's a very happy fellow. There, she's congratulating you. Now, we welcome you and ask you to tell us about yourself.
I live in Orange County. I'm retired.
Now listen, there's no reason for you to be nervous or have any tension or anything like that, because we're a friendly, loving bunch.
Yeah.
I know you are.
Yes.
I watch you every day.
Good.
So, you're gonna have a
what are you
time.
Retired from?
Dental assistant.
Okay. Anything else you want to tell us about you?
Well, I have a lovely daughter and son-in-law, Joyce and Fred, and two wonderful grandchildren.
Right.
Johnny and Jennifer, and I wish I could say hello to them.
You want to say hello to Johnny and Jennifer?
They're home.
Oh, I'm sorry, that's not allowed.
Johnny and Jennifer. I'll let her
say it, Jane.
What
is that little thing there?
I found that in the backstage.
A penny? You found a penny? Whoops, and you brought us the penny. That's going to be your lucky penny there.
Thanks.
All right, good luck to you, my dear. We'll begin this game right now by asking you to make a selection. You may have A or B.
A.
You going to be all right?
I'm going to be fine.
Yes. Isabel Smith.
Isabel. So we're just having a game, that's all, right?
Sure.
We're just having a game, okay?
And Isabel's my middle name. So
sure.
Just think of it as a game, that's
yeah.
all.
You're in business.
I don't like it because it sounds like Jezebel.
Oh!
Well, she doesn't like her name.
Well, she's depressed about
yes,
her name.
She doesn't like her name because it sounds like awful. Jezebel.
We didn't know why you were depressed.
I thought she was nervous about being on television.
No,
she doesn't care about that. What the heck?
That's her name,
it sounds. All right, we must press on
all
here,
right.
Jezebel.
Of course we must.
Poor Henry.
Aww.
He turned his big bedroom fan on reverse and it sucked his blank out the window.
The winning card.
Oh, the winning card. Yeah.
Yeah.
There's your lucky card souvenir signed by Richard and the others there.
What is it again?
Poor Henry, he turned his big bedroom fan on reverse and it sucked his blank out the window.
To finish.
Oh, no, that's
good. No, that's good.
Some days,
oh,
it's
boy.
Like this.
We've got to get her up.
Okay, Mary, it's you and me. Here we go, Isabel. Poor Henry. He turned his big bedroom fan on reverse, and it sucked his blank out the window.
Toupee?
Toupee! Did you throw away toupee?
I told him.
I did. I
you
really
threw
did.
Away toupee?
Yes,
you
thought it'd be too heavy. Yes.
Well, I must say she does give the impression of
don't,
being a sweet.
Don't ever do that. That's terrible. Instead, I went with wife.
I'm sure his wife is. Oh, that's a good one. All right.
Sorry, I'll never do that again.
Well, he was really very upset because it was his little bride of only 3 hours.
Oh, well. Oh, that was terrible. Chuck?
His date, a cocktail waitress from Encino who we met in the parking lot.
My goodness. Poor Henry. He's really having a hard time here, Mary.
Isabel, you know I told you my name was Mary Isabel? Toupee.
Oh! show her your hairpiece.
Wife.
I'll take it off and show it, Dad.
Go on, take it. The hair lace is sticking out like a country
plumb awning.
Okay, Joyce.
I wish I'd said toupee. I said wife.
Okay, so there you are. One for you, Isabel, and you stand by. But right now we've got this for you. Hello there. Shall we carry on? All right, David, we got a first-round question for you. Remember the little tougher Norma said to her husband.
Oh. Yes?
I don't mind if your brother stays with us, but does he have to play handball in the blank? I don't mind if your brother stays with us, but does he have to play handball in the blank?
Very suggestive question.
Yes. Okay. You got rhythm.
Where?
You got music.
In green pastures, isn't it?
In handball. Green pastures. Okay, Brett, we're waiting for you. Well, I'll read it to you while she's finishing up here, David. Norma said to her husband, I don't mind if your brother stays with us, but does he have to play handball in the blank?
Living room.
Living room. Living room, eh? Living room, he said.
I felt that a wife would really take offense of anybody playing handball in the kitchen.
Indeed, she would. You know, that's don't know that.
That's bad also. Bad. What room do you got?
What do you got?
Well, I figure your children, they always play handball, but I thought a funny place, an odd, peculiar, eccentric place would be the hall closet.
The hall closet. Well, now, there are closet handball players.
Oh.
There.
And other things.
Hello, Chuck.
Well, as there always is on this game once in a while, a John.
A John, of course. That's the answer. By Jove, that's a definitive answer. Excellent. Well done. Now, Mary Wicks, she's looking for the answer, living room.
I'm going to give you an answer that's going to knock you right off your feet.
Okay.
I could thought of all them tile walls. I said in the bathroom.
Bathroom.
I knew it would.
Knocked me right off my
feet. You're going to ruin that suit.
Yes. All right, Richard, looking for a living room.
Well, as the wife was not in any, you know, the rooms, I don't think that'd bother him. What would, I think, really
point,
bother
Richard.
Her is if he played handball in the nude.
Yeah. Splendid
quick
answer.
Service break.
Right. Joyce?
Mine might be a little unusual.
Oh, really? Naturally.
But I thought about, I said in the bed, because I thought against the headboard.
Uh-huh. Does he have to play handball in the bed?
Oh, my.
Yes, it's quite unusual.
Joyce has an odd
one. Put it down. Put it down.
Really? Okay, here we go to round two. Isabel, you may have A or B.
A.
A it is. A for Isabel.
Oh, that's par for the course.
Are you familiar with the song, You Make Me Feel Like Dancing? Yes.
No.
You do that. Well, anyway, there's a new song out written by Ugly Edna's boyfriend. It's called You Make Me Feel Like Blanking. All right, Isabel, you think about that answer?
I do.
We'll ask you to give it to us right now. The song You Make Me Feel Like Dancing. Well, there's a new song out written by Ugly Edna's boyfriend. It's called You Make Me Feel Like Blanking.
Dying.
When you go all the way, huh? Oh,
that's a heavy shot.
That goes all the way there.
Well, I'm more in the stomach area, barfing.
Barfing.
Had
a good one.
Come to my house.
Yeah. All right.
He has come up with a lot of the popular faves, hasn't he?
Yes, he has indeed.
Vomiting.
Oh, no. All right.
He's a what? A songwriter?
Yes. No, there's a new song out written by Ugly Edna's
boyfriend. No, written by Ugly Edna's boyfriend.
Yeah. Right.
Now, barfing and vomiting is a very hard word to put in a song.
Right.
So I chose regurgitating.
Regurgitating. Yeah. Yes, simple rhymes, of course. Anything rhymes with regurgitating. Richard?
I'm larfing while you're barfing.
You're larfing while I'm barfing, eh? Okay.
I was going to be very ladylike and say expectorating. But yeah. The last time I said that, I got in trouble and I couldn't spell it and everything else, so I said barfing.
Okay. So there we are at the middle of round two. The score is 1-0, and that puts you in the catbird seat, because all you got to do is match 1 to tie and 2 to win. But we don't do that now. Right now, we do this for you. Next time we get together, these are the people you will meet in person.
George Kennedy, Rex Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Lee Merriweather, Richard Dawson, and Betty White.
You were wonderful.
Get ready to match the stars. Gary Crosby, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Mary Wicks, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Dillavance as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Reilly.
Here we go again. This will tie it up here.
I mean, we've been all tied up here for days and days and days. But we're going to see if we can untie it with your assistance.
Right.
Here we have Maggie Lantizer and David Zive. We welcome them. They played one game to a tie. Then they went to a tiebreaker, and they tied that. Now we got to go to another tiebreaker. Are you ready for it?
Yes.
Will you stop fooling around here and play this game right? We'll see how this game ends right after we see about this. Shall we? Okay, here we go. Second tiebreaker. David Zive, you may have A or B.
B, please.
B. All right. David is a medical technician. A tall medical technician.
He can play anyway.
6'7". Here it is. Hopalong Cassidy said, "The reason they call me Hopalong is that before I got my horse, I used to ride a blank." They gave us most frequently. And if you match their second most popular answer, you get $250 and then $100 for matching the third. And three of the six are allowed to help.
Gary.
Patrick Henry.
Yeah! Richard.
Patrick McGoohan.
Patrick McGoohan. Yeah.
Gentlemen who starred in The Prisoner, the television series.
Oh, yes, indeed. Yes. Excellent.
Brett.
Very good. Just a minute. Something may come to me. But then again, something may not.
McNee!
Patrick McNee. Oh, yes. He did that series, The Avengers, with what's-her-name for so long.
Diana Rigg.
Diana Rigg. Now, so you have Diana Rigg. No, you have Patrick Henry, Patrick McNeil, and Patrick McGoohan.
I go Gary. Patrick Henry.
Patrick Henry. You just mentioned him yesterday, didn't you?
When
you
said, "Shoot if you must." I was talking about him at breakfast. I said, right. "Whatever became of it."
Here we go. Patrick Henry. May we see the $100 number? Patrick Moynihan, senator from New York State. All right, here we go with the $250 number. Patrick McGoohan is Richard's answer. All right, last chance for you, Henry. Here we go. Yeah. David, you picked up an additional $500.
Oh, yeah.
And that means you have a total of $600 now. However, you are going to play for 10 times the sum you just won, or $5,000. You could. Okay. Well, David, they had another idea there. Yours now, Maggie, 1 to tie and 2 to win. The lawyer said to the assembled relatives, "I'm afraid this will has an unusual requirement. Before I can read it, you must you all must be blank.
This will has an unusual requirement.
I'm afraid this will has an unusual requirement. Before I can read it, you all must be blank.
Most unusual.
Right? Right, Gino?
Right.
You can't get no more unusualer.
Right. Ready, Chuck? Yay, Chuck! Okay, Maggie. The lawyer said to the assembled relatives, I'm afraid this will has an unusual requirement. Before I can read it, you all must be blank.
Drunk?
Drunk? Drunk.
That's unusual.
That is unusual.
Not a bad idea.
Rich grandfather died, and they all got drunk at the reading of the will there. Is that what that's
I got
what
too
said?
Unusual, didn't I?
You got too unusual.
Dead.
He said dead.
As long as I keep them straight.
Yeah, right.
They could come up after you, those people.
Right, they're in the parking lot. They could get you. Okay.
With my reputation, this is going to come as a shock, but I said Dade.
Dade! Looking for drunk.
I didn't do a thing, Mr. Rayburn.
I know, but the gesture with your head was beautifully done.
Edward Everett Horton taught me that. Dead.
The lawyer said the most unusual requirement in this will, before I can read it, you all must be drunk, according to Maggie.
Well, I'm all for it, but I said dead.
Dead. All right, Maggie, you're getting down to the home stretch here. You got to match one to achieve a tie again.
Dead.
Now, you got to match Joyce to achieve a tie. And if you don't, David will win. What do you say?
Not drunk, dead drunk.
Dead. That means David wins. Maggie is leaving here with a pretty good-sized bundle of money. She's got $600 to her credit and our best wishes for being on Match Game 77. Maggie Lantau, goodbye. And while we're spinning her off, here's the message we want to send for you. Here we are with David Zive, who's a lot taller than 6'5".
Suppose
you were in a play with him and you were doing a love scene.
This is my twin brother.
Really? On his knees, he's taller than you are. 6'7", you are?
Right.
Do you use the same hair color?
Get back to your seat, you rascal. You use the same hair color. Now, David, here's the way it is. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, and we gave them pencil and crayon, and we said, you write down your best answer to this. Patrick Blank. And we'll be happy to give you $500 if you match the answer.
Got it. Well.
It's all right. Okay, David. Hopalong Cassidy said the reason they call me Hopalong is... Before I got my horse, I used to ride a blank.
Pogo stick.
Pogo stick. Pogo stick is good.
I think that's okay. Saying, but that dates you pretty good. Pogo stick
Pogo
hasn't
stick.
Been seen since high button shoes.
Where did I go wrong? I
what?
Thought I had it.
Really?
Yeah.
What do you
rabbit.
Think?
Rabbit.
Rabbit. They don't think you went wrong. They're with
so
you, Gary.
On my side?
Right.
Wait, I did too. Big. I said rabbit.
Before I got my horse, I used to ride a rabbit. Hop along. Oh, yeah. Rabbits go hippity-hoppity, hippity-hoppity.
Well, his name is Hoppy. That's
Hoppy.
His nickname, Hopalong Cassidy.
Hoppy.
Isn't it Hoppy?
Right.
Hoppy.
Used to be Hoppy.
Right.
Well, don't turn on me. I'm just trying to keep the show alive and moving.
Yes, in Christopher Robin. Don't you remember that famous phrase?
No.
He went hippity-hoppity.
I was reading more adult books at the time.
Oh, I see.
So, anyway, I couldn't think of the name of this animal for a while, so I put those things in Australia. Then it came to me, a kangaroo.
Kangaroo, that's a good one. Not a good jumper. David is looking for the answer, pogo stick.
I hope this won't embarrass anyone. Pogo stick.
Pogo stick. That's a bouncy device,
yeah.
Hopping along.
True, but you can't throw a saddle on it.
Really?
But you could on a rabbit.